garbage management plan is my second video on MARPOL and XJF5. The first was garbage record book. Annexure 5, Regulation 10.2, the full regulation of the MARPOL is quoted word by word. Please look into the last sentence. They say that the garbage management plan has to be developed as per MEPC 7138, MEPC Circular 37, and it has to be made or written in the working language of the group. The general index of the plan is just given for example or sample. These are what the titles of the topics are going to be. This will change depending on type of ship, the run of the ship, and the company procedures and the audit requirements. Also, as per any changes which are coming up with the MARPOL. In the title page, the record of revisions has to be there. The title page should have the company logo, name, and the name of the ship. Then it has to highlight if the ship is sailing in polar region or not. In case a bulk carrier, if she carries solid bulk cargo, from which date the plan is effective, any revisions which are coming as per the page, date and remark, if this is required for audit purpose. The objective of the garbage management plan is systematic planning to control the garbage, the guidelines for the implementation, also the collection, storage, processing and discharge of ship generated garbage, then the designated person on board with the responsibility for execution of the garbage management plan. All garbage as per requirement is not to be thrown in the sea except a limited exceptions, and this is what is mentioned in here. The garbage which is considered to be harmful to marine environment are not permitted to be discharged. How to be discharged the other garbage is mentioned. The exceptions are always there, especially for the safety of the ship. Accidental loss of garbage. And third is, in case we have to retain the food, that can create an imminent health risk. So we need to discharge that, especially when the vessel is near the coast at anchorage. How the treatment is carried out? Let us go into the detail of the treatment. All plastic items, including material which has got mixed plastic, it has got a coating of plastic, it has to be treated. Either it has to be landed to shore or incinerated on board. In case you have an incinerator, the incinerator should very clearly mention whether it can incinerate. Non-IAPP approved incinerator is there, then you have to check whether all plastics cannot be incinerated. Over. Food waste. We have to pass the food waste through the commutator and then only it can be thrown or it can be put through the commutator and then it will go overboard, or it has to go after 12 miles. In case of special areas, even if you are passing through the commutator, it has to be away from 12 nautical miles from the nearest land. Okay. A person who is operating the commutator has to be careful that the ship is not rolling in rough seas, and he has to be careful regarding the safety. Category C is domestic waste. Glass bottles, cans, crockery, expired medicine, injections, syringes and other medical waste. these which do not contain chemical or it did not have chemical, that is coming in domestic waste. And it is very clearly mentioned they have to be recycled. The sign of recycle is also shown, which means that they have to be sent ashore for recycling. In case you find this sign, that means this particular domestic, it has to be sent for recycling. Cooking oil has to be either sent ashore or incinerated, that is burned. In case we are incinerating, then it has to be soaked in the oily rags and then burned. Category E is incinerator ash. After the incineration, it has to be put in a drum and we have to put a lid. We have to keep in a space which has got a fire detector. Next is the clinker ash, that is the coal ash, is not to be included with other ash which is being burnt, and it has to be landed ashore separately. Category F. This is operational waste. These are different. The operational waste are containing some sort of chemicals, paints, lubes, which are harmful to the sea. Even if they are empty, they have to be kept separately and landed ashore. For example, the glass bottles, the can drums for chemicals and paints, the welding rods, paint drums, glass wool, pyrotechnics, the furniture, oily rags and dragger tubes. These are just the example. Also, please refer to the company manual. The next comes is the cleaning agent, which is coming again in category F, and it is in the part of the operational waste. It can be discharged. This cleaning agent, which is there for cleaning the hold, the deck, the external surface, it can only be discharged when the marine environment is not harmful, and then the producer or the agent has to supply a certificate stating that this is not harmful to the marine environment. The record of this document or statement has to be preserved and kept for next 2 years for audit purpose. This cleaning has to be done while the vessel is en route and as far as practicable from the nearest land. Exemptions with the water is the grey water, the bilge water, the water from the chain locker, fire main system water, freshwater layup, machinery waste water, pool, recreation water, and any other similar discharges essential to be operational on the ship. They can be pumped overboard. Animal carcasses is category G. This is applied on cattle carrier, not for other ships. But in case on other ships they find a dead bird or a fish, try and throw it once the vessel is more than 100 nautical miles or as instructed in your company manual, but not in special area. Fishing nets applies to fishing vessels, but in case we find nets, please treat them as plastic, especially in case they are plastic nets. They have to be landed ashore. You will get plastic nets while heaving up anchor, or in case you are cleaning up the rudder and propeller, there will be a lot of plastic which will be coming up. Please ensure that this is landed ashore. Category I is e-waste. Electrical equipment, broken device, printers, batteries, fluorescent lamp, light bulbs. This has to be sent only to shore and they have to be stored properly. The next slide, which is giving special areas, and the special areas as per the map is North Sea, Baltic Sea, Black Sea, Gulf areas, Persian Gulf, Red Sea, Mediterranean Sea, wider Caribbean region, including the Gulf of Mexico and the Caribbean Sea. The Arctic area, I am not covering the polar code. They have special rules for that. How do the chief cook know that we are not in the special areas? It is normally marked on the chart and he has to ring up the bridge to check whether we are in the special area or not. And it is the duty of the navigator to inform him that we are in special areas, not to throw the food overboard. The next placard, which was also shown in my last video, is regarding how we treat the garbage, whether the disposal, what can be thrown overboard and what cannot be thrown overboard. It is for the ships, including the platforms, and you can go and double check. And such placards are on mostly on all ships, and they give detail over storing and processing. The garbage management policy will inform how you are going to do the disposal of such food waste, retention till the ship has cleared a restricted area, compacting of reduction of space, especially for plastic, special attention for battery, chemical and medical waste, and recycling item, how they have to be kept and where they have to be landed. The next slide is storing of the garbage, the food waste to be sealed in airtight. It has to be disinfected and pest control to be carried out regularly. All garbage to be stored in the covered leak-proof container. It has got a liquid and it is seeping out. The port state control will have a remark or it can fine you for the same. Your containers have to be leak-proof. Oily rags are not to be kept in hot places, for example, incinerator or galley. The last, but not the least, but very important, is the training. Every seafarer is getting training regarding garbage before joining. Once he comes on the ship, he has a complete look and he gets completely familiarized. What are his duties regarding the garbage? Especially for the operation of incinerator, the engineers need to be given training. In case the incinerator is non-IMO compliant, then the engineer has to be informed that certain plastics cannot be burned. The chief cook has to be given training for his equipments, and training is equally important. Thank you very much. I have covered most of the items in these two videos and I hope you like them. Thank you.